Then, to Dimpna's horror, she saw a positive tribe of small, dark-haired men in naval uniform descending on the floor, and in 2 seconds it was bedlam. Men were punching and thumping and using dreadful language. Girls were trying to get between their men and the fight, and the management were running onto the floor. Even the band had stopped playing and were apprehensively gripping their instruments as though wondering whether to flee with them whilst the going was good or whether to use them in self-defence. Dimpna, rooted to the spot, scarcely noticed as girls began to hurry past her out of harm's way. She was staring at the mass of struggling, fighting bodies. How on earth had this happened, and so quickly? And where in God's name was Jimmy? A hand grasped her arm.
Come on out of it, gal,
Elsie's voice said in her ear.
What happened, eh? Out to the side of the room. I didn't see nothing.
Two fellers started punching, Dimpna said. Innate caution advised her not to spill the beans completely. Not now.
Oh, Else, the chap I was dancing with is under that lot somewhere. What'll I do?
Skedaddle, Elsie said briefly. No fella's worth getting a split lip for, let alone being carted off by the scuffers. Come on.
She set off in the direction of the cloakroom, but Dimpna, poised on the very edge of the dance floor and gazing helplessly into the heaving mound of fighting men, had just seen Jimmy emerging from the fracas with what looked like a black eye and his shirt collar torn clean off. And in the moment that she saw him, she also saw a matelot grab a tall glass from a nearby table, smash it against a chair, and advance purposefully upon Jimmy with the jagged remains of the glass held at shoulder level.
Jimmy, look out!
Dimpna shrieked and cast herself at the matelot. She hit him squarely amidships with her shoulder, and the two of them went down in a tangled heap.